I just instantly associated John Bradbury with, you know, Santa Barbara and that scene. And the funny thing is, the photo they ran of him, it was like a candid, just a headshot. He looked scary. He was like this sort of underground shaper that made beautiful boards for places like the ranch and Rincon.
I was probably more influenced by Bradbury and the boards he was making, the type of boards he was making. It was more the direction I was looking at. And then when I made my first boards, it was, you know, similar to probably what John Bradbury had been making. I thought he was a great shaper and, you know, one of the pioneers in the area along with Rennie. Certainly pioneer for shortboard up in the area, and he made just good boards, good solid boards, you know, surfed at the ranch and was a good surfer. And when I came up here, I got my first board from John.
One of the things about John is that he would shape a board with something new, maybe like he had those rails, instead of it being so that the rail line would go like this, then it would kind of get a chine on. Remember those tails had that little chine on them? He'd go to Rincon, surf it, and leave the water about 9 o'clock, drive home, take the chines off, re-glass it, and go back down and surf in the afternoon. He was an artist.
Surfing the 70s in Santa Barbara is magical because there was so much change in surfboards.
Watching them shape your board, he was like such a perfectionist because it was all hand shaped.
Always looking for new ideas and very progressive and very innovative, really hard worker. He put his heart and soul into every single board he made.
In walks John, introduces himself, and he walks. And I said, you know, I'd like to learn how to do it. I said, okay, I'll teach you.